Paris for a day. Oliver drives a cab in Paris. He is an employee of fast cabs. I like going through the city in my car. Samuel, Oliver's boss, calls him one day. It's a very early morning. Samuel asks Oliver, "Oliver, can you be at the Parisian Hotel at 9 a.m?" "Yes," Oliver says. "But why?" Samuel, his wife, and their two kids, Daniel and Emily, are having breakfast. "Tom Hanks is in Paris," Samuel says. Oliver says, "Tom Hanks, the famous actor. Where do you want me to take him?" "Not him," says Samuel. Jake, who is 12 years old, wants to see Paris today while his mom is at work. "A letter for you and 50 others are at the Parisian," Samuel says. "Say, that's for Jake. $50 for a day in Paris." Oliver shouts, "That is a good amount of money." "I know," says Samuel. "Be nice to the boy and don't be late, Oliver." "You already know me," Oliver says. "I always show up on time." Oliver gets to the Parisian 15 minutes early. It is 8:45 a.m. He walks up to the front desk. "I'm from Fast Cabs," he tells her. He gets the letter and the money from the woman behind the desk. "This is Jake's first time in Paris," the letter says. "Please take him to the Eiffel Tower, the Louvre Museum, and Notre Dame Cathedral." "All right," Oliver thinks. "Is Jake still not here? Even though I'm early." A boy is sitting in a chair, which he sees. "Hello," says he. "Are you Jake?" "That's me," the boy replies. "Are you one of the drivers from Fast Cabs?" "Yes," Oliver says in answer. Jake stands up. He says, "All right. Let's go." First, Oliver drives to Paris's most famous landmark, the Eiffel Tower. He sets the taxi down. "What's going on?" Jake asks. "I'd rather not see this old building." Oliver watches him. "But I..." Then he remembers what Samuel said, "Be kind to the boy." "Okay, Jake," he says. "What do you want to do?" Oliver stops the taxi once more after 5 minutes. He asks, "Is this the place?" "Exactly," says Jake. "Please give me 20. "But I don't think that your mother..." "I want 20. Now." Oliver gives the money to Jake and then waits in the car. Jake comes back 3 hours later. "Are you hungry right now?" Oliver asks. "Yes, I am," answers Jake. "Very, very hungry." Oliver drives to a restaurant not too far away. He says, "There's a great restaurant here." Jake says, "I don't want to eat here." "That's where I want to eat lunch." Oliver wants to know, "Where?" He looks in the other direction. Jake walks into a cozy cafe and gives the cashier another 20. He eats a lot of food and drinks 4 milkshakes. In the taxi, Oliver eats his lunch. He thinks, 20 for lunch. If I had $20, I could buy food for a week. He eats another sandwich and stares out the window. After an hour, Jake comes out of the restaurant. Be very nice to the boy, Oliver tells himself. He asks, do you want to go to the Louvre Museum right now? Okay, answers Jake. Oliver takes a look at him. Yes? Oliver is so happy. He drives to the Louvre and gives Jake $10. Thanks, says Jake. Wait right here. He then goes to a nearby movie theater. It is just on the other side of the road from the museum. Jake leaves the movie theater at 4:15 p.m. Oliver is very angry as he sits in the cab. He tries to stay calm as he asks, where do you want to go now? Oh, I think I'll go back to the Parisian, says Jake. I'm tired and want to take a bath before dinner. Very well, Oliver says to himself. He again starts the car. Oliver pulls up in front of the hotel at 4:30 p.m. Here we are, he tells Jake as he opens the door. He sees a beautiful woman wearing an expensive coat all of a sudden. As she leaves the Parisian, she looks at Oliver. I know that woman, Oliver says to himself. Then he thinks about it. Of course, it's Angelina Jolie. Are you the fast cab's driver? Angelina asks. Yes, Oliver says. Come with me, the movie star says. She goes back to the hotel and walks in. Oliver goes inside and sees a sad-looking boy sitting in a chair. This is Jake, she tells him. But... Oliver stammers, unable to speak. I am furious, says Angelina. Oliver looks at the young boy, then at the movie star, and then back at the boy. He says, but this can't be Jake. Angelina says back, young man, I know my son. Where is my 50? Oliver's face turns pale. He peers through the window. His taxi is there, but Jake is nowhere to be found. It's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Samuel, who is Oliver's boss, is at home with his wife. They are having a cup of tea when the door opens and their son, Daniel, comes in. Hello, Daniel, says Samuel. Did you enjoy school today? Daniel looks elated. Yes, thank you, he replies. That was great. Oliver drives all day and then goes back to the fast cab's office. He talks about all the strange things that happened. His coworkers find the mix-up funny and can't stop laughing at Oliver's bad luck. Oliver learns from what happened and starts being more careful when he picks up passengers. Before he goes on a trip, he checks the names again to make sure he has the right person. Angelina Jolie's meeting with Oliver gets around, and he becomes known as the taxi driver to the stars. When famous people come to Paris, they start asking Oliver to be their driver. This leads to exciting meetings and interesting stories. Oliver's life takes a turn he didn't expect when a famous director comes up to him. The director was impressed by Oliver's meetings with famous people, so he offered him a part in his next movie as a taxi driver who likes to get into trouble. Oliver takes the chance and starts acting on the side, splitting his time between driving taxis and working on movie sets. His coworkers tease him about his newfound fame, but they are still happy for him. As Oliver's acting career grows, he realizes that he loves telling stories more than acting. He starts writing a book about the people he has met and the exciting things he has done as a taxi driver. The book is full of interesting stories about the people he has met and the things he has done. The book sells a lot of copies and gets the attention of readers all over the world. Oliver's skill as a writer has won him praise from critics and many literary awards. Oliver decides to quit his job as a taxi driver after his book does well. "I quit my job as a truck driver to write full-time." He starts writing his second book, which will be a collection of short stories set in cities all over the world. Oliver's writing takes him on an exciting journey where he meets his readers, goes to book signings, and takes part in literary festivals. He becomes a famous author who is known for the way his words can take people to different places. Oliver meets up with Gloria, a childhood friend who wants to become a photographer, while he is writing. They work together to make a unique project that combines Oliver's stories with Gloria's interesting pictures. When they work together, they make a stunning art show that travels to big cities to show the beauty and variety of the world through their creative eyes. Oliver and Gloria's project gets the attention of a well-known travel magazine, which leads to them working together on a series of articles that encourage readers to see the world and discover new places. Oliver's fame keeps growing, but he will never forget that he started out as a taxi driver. He starts a foundation to help poor kids get an education, and he uses some of the money he makes to help them reach for their dreams. Oliver's foundation becomes a worldwide success, changing the lives of many children and giving them a chance at a better future. He gets a lot of joy and satisfaction from making the world a better place. Even though he is successful, Oliver stays humble and enjoys the simple things in life. He spends time with the people he cares about, takes long walks along the Seine, and enjoys the beautiful sights of Paris. Oliver's second book does better than his first and becomes a bestseller. It makes people want to travel and encourages them to go after their dreams without fear. Oliver is asked to speak at a prestigious international writers' conference because of what he has done for literature and charity. He talks about his inspiring journey and encourages people who want to write to be proud of their own stories and use their words to make a difference. Oliver's speech makes people feel good, which leads to invitations to give motivational speeches at events and universities around the world. He becomes a popular speaker who encourages people to follow their dreams and make a positive difference in the world. Oliver starts a scholarship program for aspiring writers from poor backgrounds. He does this because he wants to give back. The program gives these writers a mentor, advice, and money to help them reach their goals as writers. Oliver's influence goes beyond just the world of literature. He works with environmental groups and uses his fame to spread the word about sustainability and how important it is to take care of the planet. The French government gives Oliver the prestigious Legion of Honor award because of how much he cares about both art and helping people. Oliver and his loved ones feel a lot of pride during the ceremony. As Oliver thinks back on his amazing journey, he realizes that life's turns and twists often lead to adventures and chances you never saw coming. He welcomes each new chapter with open arms, eager to discover all the new things that can happen. Oliver finds comfort in writing poetry, which allows him to capture the essence of fleeting moments and the deep beauty of everyday life. His poems move people's hearts and give them a look into how people really feel. Oliver's legacy continues to inspire more and more people with each passing year. His stories, acts of kindness, and unwavering love of telling stories leave an indelible mark on the world and remind us all to embrace life's adventures and make our own extraordinary journeys.